in time of crisis. According to Webster, battle means to fight or struggle, to achieve or resist something. In our physical life, battle are the things that we're fighting against physically, and they can sometimes be unpredictable. There are battles against high blood pressures, battle against arthritis, battle against diabetes, battle against cancer, battle against AIDS, battle against depression, battle against stress, and the list goes on and on. Be mindful on the spiritual level. We are also fighting a battle. According to Ephesians 6:12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against power, against ruler of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. But if we stand, no matter how difficult the battle, our battle becomes God's battle. Jehoshaphat learned that this battle will be fought by God. Jehoshaphat was the king of Judea. He was in a crisis. He was surrounded by a coalition of army known as the Moabites, the Ammonites, and the Edomites. Be mindful that these army had assembled themselves and were in the process of attacking the people of Judea. Jehoshaphat felt his only refuge was at the horns of the altar. So he called upon the people to get serious with God by fasting and praying. And my brother and my sister, if there ever been a time we need to get serious about praying, it's time like this. This nation is in a crisis. Whether you want to turn a blind eye to it or a deaf ear to it, the United States is in a crisis. Old folks were saying like this, it's in a crisis. And things gonna get worse before it get better.
Come on, guys.
So if we ever need to pray, it's time like this. But it was a custom for the king to proclaim a fast in a dangerous and a risky situation. On this occasion, it was a universal fast, which extended all the way to infants. Jehoshaphat, he led the people in prayer. Understand that when Israel left Egypt, that these were the same folks. These were the same people that God had commanded them not to hunt. Now years later, these Moabites and Ammonites and Edomites, they had joined forces. And they were trying to destroy Judea. So Jehoshaphat, he appealed to God, was for him to remember that their present trouble was the result of their obedience to him. And can I just make it plain? And that's in Jehoshaphat saying, now Lord, when you had commanded us leave alone.
Yeah.
These same folk you told them don't say nothing to.
Yeah.
Now they come around and want to do some harm. Are y'all with me? Am I doing all right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now as they pray, God answer their prayer to the prophet Jesus.
Yeah. Yeah.
In verse 14, God told them, I'm paraphrasing, don't be afraid.
Right.
Don't stress yourself. Don't worry yourself about nothing that you can't do about it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Don't go around trying to throw yourself no pity.
To waste my time fussing and arguing with nobody.
may not be at Mount Zion to next first Sunday, but I'm gonna preach today. We got to understand, my brother and sister, certain things.
Yes, sir.
You have to let ain't gonna ride up. Do you know him? Has he been good to you? He